next step is going to be to dye the leather. The little bit of a challenge we're going to have is we have to get inside the belt loop because I didn't dye this area before I sewed this on. So we're going to have to get a lot on our dauber and get it in here the best we can, and it'll run down inside. It should run down in there good enough. Okay. Should get in all the corners. Not much left in this bottle. That's why you see me dropping it in. There's only a little bit on the bottom. I do have another bottle, but I don't think I'll need it. The edge is going to take a lot. That's going to soak a lot up. Okay, that should be good. I'm going to hang it up to dry. The next step is going to be to burnish this edge. I want to try and smooth this edge out some. So I'm going to use this stuff to do it. I'm not even going to try and pronounce this. I'm just going to call this a burnishing agent. See, it says burnishing gum. I'm going to apply it to the leather. Sometimes it's just easier to use your finger on this stuff. This stuff won't hurt you, so it's okay. we're just going to take, you can use a wooden dowel, you can even use a screwdriver, and we're going to work and work this stuff in and rub it. What that stuff is going to do is soften the leather a little bit. So when we rub it, we push all the fibers down and we get a nice smooth surface. See the difference in that already? Let me actually show you what it'll do on this surface, because this is the rough side of the leather. I don't have to do this, but just show you how good this stuff works. I may get out of frame a few times here. See that? Isn't that nice? How that smoothed out that rough side. I'm gonna do just a little bit more along here. Can see how that looks. A lot better than it did before. Okay, we're gonna let this harden and we'll come back for the next step.